A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Mark. Jesus said to his disciples, "Be watchful, be alert. You do not know when the time will come. It is like a man traveling abroad. He leaves home and places his servants in charge, each with his work, and orders the gatekeeper to be on the watch. Watch therefore. You do not know when the Lord of the house is coming, whether in the evening, or at midnight, or at cockcrow, or in the morning. May he not come suddenly and find you sleeping. What I say to you, I say to all, watch." The Gospel of the Lord. Waiting in joyful hope. Advent is the church liturgical season calling for vigilance, yet brimming with hope. Regarding the elusive virtue of hope, believers receive some solid advice from Scripture. Always be ready to give an explanation to anyone who asks of you for a reason for your hope. However, one may sincerely ask, are these words of advice realistic and practical in our contemporary context? We live in a world that seems at times devoid of genuine hope. We can easily list many depressing and difficult realities: broken families, growing poverty, disenchanted youth, endemic government corruption, random violence, proliferation of illegal drugs, and it even appears that nothing changes. Are we Christians simply naive and dangerously out of touch with the real world when we speak of hope, source of our hope? The writings of Paul expresses the well and true source and object of Christian hope. In an illuminating passage, Paul affirms, "Through our Lord Jesus Christ, we have gained access by faith to this grace, in which we stand and we boast in hope of the glory of God. Not only that, but we even boast of our afflictions, knowing that affliction produces endurance, and endurance proven character, and proven character hope, and hope does not disappoint, because the love of God has been poured out into our hearts." What evidence do Christians give as the basis of their hope? Simply, God's unfathomable love has been manifested in the unique gift of His incarnate Son, Jesus, Emmanuel, God with us. Thus, Christians during Advent at Christmas and always remain people of hope. With Paul, they affirm, "We are afflicted in every way, but not constrained, perplexed, but not driven in despair, persecuted, but not abandoned, struck down, but not destroyed." Communicating hope. Here we face a very difficult challenge, effectively witnessing to hope in our broken world. How do we bridge people's fears and frustrations with Christian hope? We Christians, as missionaries of hope, begin with a profound acceptance of life's realities and people's growing anxieties. Secondly, the missionary of hope will communicate the true source of Christian hope, Christ our Savior. In addition, the missionary of hope, through words and concrete actions, manifests solidarity with the suffering and those on the peripheries of society. It is this personal people engagement and sincere service that become the fertile ground in which the seed of hope is nurtured and grows. God alone is our hope, even within a broken world, a wounded humanity. God's loving presence, born for us in Bethlehem, engenders hope. God's profound presence enables believers to live in joyful hope. We Christians boldly affirm, our God is a God of hope. Our God brought hope, both through His birth in Bethlehem and His death on Calvary. Our incarnate and crucified risen God remains the only source of joyful hope everywhere and at all times, during Advent, and always become a missionary of hope.